bold. That's how we'll always be inseparable. Just you and me. It's so wonderful to know you'll always be around.
Beloved, we're gathered together here in the sight of God to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. It is an honorable estate, instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union that is between Christ and his church. That holy estate Christ adorned and beautified with his presence and first miracle in Cana of Galilee. It is commended in the scriptures to be honorable among all, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, in fear of the God. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. Would you bow with me just one moment, please? Would you touch somebody next to you, please? Father, we just thank you for this moment, this day. Thank you for this couple. Thank you for the decision. And Father, let all of us, as we witness this miracle, where two become one, that we be reminded of the vows we've made to another and the covenant that's being entered into this day with you, to live in accord with your will and your way. And the people of God said,
amen.
You may be seated, please. Aaron Keith Johnson. The Word of God says, husbands, love your wives. That means putting her first. Just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word. That means every word that you speak about her and to her should be uplifting to her. And to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, you as her husband will give love and honor to her. Treena Ann Watson. The scriptures say, wives, submit yourselves to your husbands as the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands. But the scripture also says to both of you, submit to one another. Because it's a union, it's a partnership. It's not to be used to cause anyone any harm, but to be uplifting in all ways. And let your words be such that they comply with the word of God, which lifts each of you up. Marriage was instituted by God himself, and he performed the first marriage when a man and a woman have chosen each other and have come to that moment when they sincerely and publicly join in this covenant for life. They lay down on the altar a holy sacrifice to God, to each other, and to humanity. The union into which you are now about to enter is the closest and most tender in which human beings can come. It is a union founded upon mutual experience and affection, and to believers of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is a union of the Lord. Marriage is God's institution, intended for the happiness and welfare of mankind. That's why the scripture says, love is patient, love is kind, and does not envy, does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It is always protecting, always trusting, always hoping, always persevering. A union embodying such ideals is not to be entered into without great thought, and you have done so. Who gives Treena Ann Watson to be married to Aaron Keith Johnson?
We do.
Thank you. You may be seated. Aaron, I'm going to address you first, if I may, please. I want you to give her your blessing and turn toward each other. And after I say this, you're going to say, I will, all right? Got to get everything right. Look her in the eyes. Before God and these witnesses, will you, Aaron Keith Johnson, take Treena Ann Watson to be your wife?
I will.
Oh. Is that sad?
Will you love and comfort her, honor and keep her, and in joy and sorrow persevere with her in this bond, holy and unbroken, until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ? As long as you both shall live, if so, say, I will again.
I will.
I would address you, Treena Watts. Before God and these witnesses, will you, Treena Ann Watson, take Aaron Keith Johnson to be your husband? Will you love and comfort him, honor and keep him in joy and sorrow, persevere with him through this bond, holy and unbroken, until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I will.
I will.
Would you repeat after me, Mr. Johnson? Keith Johnson.
I, Aaron Keith Johnson.
Take you, Treena Ann Watson.
Take you, Treena Ann Watson.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To love you with all my heart's affection.
To love you with all my heart's affection.
To endow you with all my earthly possessions.
To endow.
I got it. I got it. We repeated. All right. All right now. All right. All right. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. To give you all my earthly possessions.
To give you all my earthly possessions.
They must know something. To give you all the honor of my name.
Give you all the honor of my name.
And to share with you the grace of my God.
And to share the grace of
my God.
Of my God.
Amen.
I told him to make it short.
This is good. Relax. You're doing well. 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 Doing well. I, Treena Ann Watson.
I, Treena Ann Watson.
Take you, Aaron Keith Johnson.
Take you, Aaron Keith Johnson.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Where you go, I will go.
Where you go, I will go.
Where you stay, I will stay.
Where you stay, I will stay.
Your people will be my people.
Your people will be my people.
And your God will be my God.
Your God will be my God.
As a token of this covenant, we're going to have a double ring ceremony. It's first for the bride. And again, it's a beautiful silver wedding ring. It's circular, indicating that there is no beginning and no ending. And that's how this relationship is in Christ.
Can I put it on that?
Oh, yeah. Look at her. That's good. Just look at her. You're fine. As a token of this covenant, Aaron Keith Johnson is giving this ring to Treena Ann Watson as a reflection of who he is and what this relationship means to him. The unbroken circle, the emblem of eternity, and that it's untarnished. And repeat after me, would you please? Look at her.
With this ring,
I do wed.
I do wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Okay. 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 Thank you so much. This is a much bigger ring. It's also circular, silver, it's fabulously beautiful. Again, it's a reflection of the love that Treena has for Aaron. It's unbroken. Look at him. With this ring, I do wed.
I do wed.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son. And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
We'll now have the singing of the Lord's Prayer. That was fabulous. That's good. A beautiful dream. What a gift. What a gift. Before I pronounce them man and wife, I'm going to share a little bit with them. I thank God for both Aaron and for Treena, and what this means for not only themselves, but also for this community. It's reflections of great patience, perseverance, and great love. This is a love story. A determination that love would prevail. So it's something for each of us to be enheartened, to learn from. Love overcomes everything. Most powerful force, universe. Because love is God. And what you've witnessed over the years and is culminating here at this moment, in this pulpit, in this church, but also being hardened for yourself. That whatever God has for you is only for you. And God will make sure that it comes true. So each of us can be glad for them and for ourselves, for both Aaron and for Treena. What wonderful people. What awesome, wonderful people. For as much as Aaron Keith Johnson and Treena Ann Watson have consented together in holy matrimony and witnessed the same before God and this company, and therefore and thereto have given their pledge, each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving rings and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may kiss your bride. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Aaron Keith Johnson. Amen.